What's your favorite Baker story? Give me your favorite one.
I'd say the Raiders game. He scrambled out and he got hit pretty hard and jumped up and he was fired up. And honestly, like I was just so impressed. You know, he has great. He's very competitive, and he has great courage. You know?
Give me a little bit more context.
he you know hikes the ball. He's you know running around outside the pocket and stuff, and starts scrambling, and runs for maybe I'd say don't quote me on this, but maybe like 25, 30 yards, and a DB or whatever hit him pretty hard. And he jumped up, said, "Woo!" You know, like he's, you know, fired up and everything. And I was just like that fire that got me hyped, you know, like at that moment, because I just, you know, saw like the intensity and the energy. So it was really exciting.
That's a game you got screwed on by the spot towards the end.
Yeah, you know, it happens. But, you know, that's in the
past.
I could say,
no, you don't have to. I'll just say those words. You don't have to, you know, take the high road and then give me the answer that,
well,
you know,
I mean,
that doesn't get you
know,
fined or anything
obviously
like that.
It sucks, you know, whatever happened, but at the end of the day, you can't change it. So
no, I know that. Did he give voice, David Njoku here on the show, did he give voice to the way the locker room felt about Hugh Jackson when he didn't go in for the hug and gave him the handshake and the Heisman, and then when asked about it, just spoke about it in plain language that you've rarely hear from a quarterback? Was he giving voice to what many people in the locker room thought, David?
Well, obviously we weren't happy with what Hugh said about us after he left, you know. It is what it is, and Baker didn't appreciate that. So, you know, we came together after Hugh left and you know, took it upon ourselves to work that extra, you know, work extra hard to finish the year off strong. So,
well, because he got a lot, Baker got a lot of heat for saying that. And I saw it, I'm like, I think he's just giving voice to what people in the locker room are saying. And that was a moment that, again, obviously you want to build around something positive. I totally understand that. And that's wins and that's excitement. And this may come across as something negative, the way that Baker had talked about it so openly, but it's still something
you can
rally around.
Like, I mean, yeah, I respect him 100%. You know, Baker has a voice, as we all do, and he didn't appreciate what happened. So, you know, it's not like we're robots. You know, we felt in a way disrespected. So that is what it is.
For more of the Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live, or download the Rich Eisen Show app.